Have you been wondering what the best controller settings are that's going to help you guys win all your fights in Season 8? Well, you've come to the right place. This season has completely changed up the meta as we know it, and having the best controller settings is going to help you adapt in no time. What's going on, guys? Man, I am back. Your motivation guy is fired up more than ever, and today, I'm going to show you the best controller settings and sensitivity that you can use to win every game of Season 8 and help you with aiming and building and, I'm telling you right now, your editing. And so by the end of the video, guys, you're going to know everything that you need to know to find the perfect settings to absolutely dominate this season. Don't tell me that you can't. Only believe that you can, and I promise you, you will do it if you put your mind to it, you put your heart into it, put your grind into it. All right, Butcher Crunch Army, it's time for the question of the day. What do you guys think is the best shotgun to use on a controller? Would you stick to the pump or lever from last season or try to get better with the charged shotgun? All right, let us know in the comments below, and you already know we're gonna check it out. So in the previous season, the shotgun meta kept changing back and forth, but this season has brought us a completely new meta. This season, the pumps and levers are staying and the charged shotgun is back. But don't get too excited, as this meta will still take you a lot of time to learn, and your controller settings will have a huge impact on how you play. So with the addition of charged shotguns, having amazing crosshair placement is just very important, as a charge is lethal when combined with a headshot, so you know your aim truly matters. This season, okay, you're gonna wanna have a sensitivity that gives you the best accuracy and gives you a balance between your building and editing, so you know you can push and fight to your best ability. So the most optimal sensitivity would be a low to medium look and ADS sensitivity and a medium to high edit and build sensitivity. You know, editing and building quicker than your opponent is crucial in a fight as it allows you to get close to them and really have the best piece control. After that, having lower to medium look sensitivity is the best for being accurate with your shots and really helps you guys finish your fight with ease. And to be a little bit more specific, all right, find your favorite controller player and just copy their settings. And this way, man, you're gonna already have some of the most optimal settings to play Season 8, and you can just adjust them to your preference. You know, we recommend using websites like Pro Settings or even find a settings video from whichever pro you prefer. And along with this, man, like our best settings would definitely be something right in the middle, but not exactly, you know, as we have just have to really get a feel for our settings and really see which ones help us play the best, right? So to get a better understanding of this, stay tuned for our favorite settings combined from your pros and just, you know, configure it for your success. These settings are tailored for players who use the linear mode, which is like what 80% of what controller pros and players in general use now. So linear is just very good for close range tracking and accuracy, but it's harder to track players when they're further away. You know, most players agree that mechanics and shotgun aim is just way better on the linear input curve and is the key to success in competitive modes. Mechanics like ADSing and shotgun aim are way easier to control in linear and are very important this season. However, you know, many also argue that exponential is just as good, especially with some of the best controller pros like, you know, Reet using it as their input curve. Exponential is just way harder to control, especially in a solo game mode where you have to rely on hitting your shots and never really messing up a build or edit. So for now, make sure to stay on linear and just practice with your new sensitivity till you feel that you're ready. And I know you're gonna be ready if you keep up the grind, I'm telling you. All right, so if you're still not able to lock onto your enemies, even though you thought you had everything completely down, I get it. Make sure that you head on over to proguides.com, where we've got an army, I'm talking about a huge army of pro coaches, ready and just waiting to really just teach you everything that you need to know about Fortnite so you can improve fast. All right, now back on the subject of the video, here we go. So you might be wondering what each setting is used for, and we got the answer. First up, controller auto run and build immediately are two settings that you need to have on. They allow you to always sprint when fighting and really help you place your builds instantly. So edit hold time should always be on the lowest so you can edit and build in perfect synchronization. Okay, so keep vibration off as it may be hectic in an in-game or just intense fights. Your edit and build mode multipliers make your sensitivity faster by what amount you set it to and should always be around 2.0 as it allows you to change your speed with ease. All right, up next, you should turn on advanced settings, like for real. These help you narrow your sensitivity down to the exact percentage. Okay, so change your look vertical and horizontal speed to around 40 to 45% and keep every other setting off in the look sensitivity section as it really just tampers with your accuracy. Look sensitivity is how fast you can move your character around and is the most important setting for having accurate aim. ADS settings, you know, which means aim down sights, help with AR, SMG, and scope weapon aim. Keep the look horizontal and vertical speed at around 7 to 14%, as lower ADS sensitivity rewards huge damage, I'm telling you. never use any boost, as they just add acceleration when aiming, and tremendously really impacts how you aim. All right, so right after, there is look dampening time, which should also remain at zero. Keep your look input curve on linear, since every single setting corresponds perfectly with linear mode. You know, there are also advanced settings that affect your gameplay, such as dead zone and aim assist strength. You know, aim assist strength is obvious, right? Like, it means really exactly what it shows. Like, always keep your aim assist strength on 100%. Anything under that, man, and you're definitely gonna have a huge disadvantage against everybody else. Dead zone is a setting that allows a small area around the thumbstick to not be detected. And so this allows you to have less stick drift and really keeps your aim aligned with your joysticks. There was also one last option, which is a foot controller. All right, so if you don't use a foot controller, which like 99% of Fortnite players don't, then keep every setting disabled in the foot controller section. All right, your controller binds are an important factor on how quickly and efficiently that you can play. You know, every single controller professional has switched over to Builder Pro years ago, right? And if you haven't, we definitely recommend that you do this, like, right now. Like, don't wait any longer. Do it right now. Thank you. Builder Pro allows you to place every build with the tap of one bind and really gives you the most control over your gameplay. Choosing binds is extremely simple on a controller, and even the default settings are optimal for competitive gameplay. You know, many pros play on default settings with like little to no changes, but you know, have modded controllers that really give them full control while playing. And so if you can, you know, spending money on pro controllers such as the Scuf Impact or Xbox Elite is definitely worth your wallet. These controllers come with almost full customizations and come with four paddles on the back of the controller. Paddles are definitely like the most useful mod on a controller, as they give you guys four extra buttons that you can press and allows all your fingers to be used at the same time. Wow. And if you still need help, you know, figuring out, you know, your controller binds, use your resources and just find binds that fit you from other professional players. A good website to really find pro player binds is Pro Settings, or just looking on YouTube. I'm telling you, man, it works. After you're done copying down those binds and other settings, you need to practice and really learn from the best. And so a great way of learning and improving on controller, guys, is by watching our previous controller videos. I'm telling you, they are dope, and it's definitely gonna help you out. Just remember, like, everybody starts at a low point, and the player with the best mentality, what? Always succeeds, I'm telling you. And so if you're having trouble adjusting at first, use that as motivation and practice consistently. The new meta has arrived, and with it are a bunch of new things to learn, even if you're a controller player. And so if you follow the tips that we've gone over in today's video, then I'm sure, man, you're gonna be beaming people out of the game in no time. Make sure that you take note of everything that we talked about, and make sure that you're playing with the optimal settings. Take the season step by step and practice consistently with your new settings. If you guys want to learn more about how to play your best in the latest season, you can always check out the rest of our channel for more tips and tricks. And if you guys found this video helpful, make sure to share it with someone else that needs these tips as well. Once again, guys, this is your motivation guy, Keith Allen, pumped up as we get into this new season where all dreams are possible. Connect with me on my Instagram at your motivation guy. Like the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't, and we'll see you next time.